In the heart of the Sumadija region, on the slopes of the rocky Oplenac hill, covered in oak forests and some 100 kilometers from the Serbian capital, stands the town of Topola. Two centuries ago, this place had become synonymous with freedom, because on the day of presentation of Jesus at the temple, on February 15, 1804, the first Serbian uprising was raised in the village of Orašac, under the guidance of Đorđe Petrović, known as Karadjordje, the battle for liberation from centuries of slavery under the Turks. Topola was the seat of rebels, but also the political administrative center of the liberated part of Serbia. According to a legend, at the place where two roads had intersected, a poplar tree had grown, in Serbian, Topola. So over the time the settlement was called the same. To this day, the overall outlook of a typical 19th century town has been preserved. It is but one of the reasons for thousands of tourists to visit Topola every year, along with Oplenac, the hill on whose slopes it stands, embedded in the nature and pure air, with high concentration of ozone. The forests hide rich fauna, so hunters like coming to Topola as well. However, one of the first associations at the mentioning of this town of Sumadija is the place chosen by kings and known for its endowments and builders, monasteries and churches, but also for its autochthonous vineyards and quality wines. When tourists come to Topola, they always visit the endowment of King Peter I, which encompasses the Church of St. George, the dynastic tomb of the Karadjordjevic family, Peter's house and the royal cellar. The Church of St. George on Oplenac dominates the landscape of this part of Sumadija. It is the five-dome church built in the Serbian Byzantine style, out of famous white marble from the nearby Vengeance mountain. It was built as the temple and mausoleum of the Karadjordjevic dynasty, and its interior is decorated with mosaics made from 14 million pieces in 15,000 shades of colors. They represent copies of most beautiful frescoes from 60 Serbian monasteries, so some experts say that this church is something of an anthology of the Serbian medieval painting art. Buried in the crypt of the church are 20 members of the dynasty, including two rulers, namely Serbian Prince Aleksandar Karadjordjevic and Yugoslav King Aleksandar I Karadjordjevic. The endowment also includes Peter's house, which is nowadays a museum gallery, with the thematic exhibition related to the Karadjordjevic dynasty, as well as the villas where members of the family stay occasionally, and the royal cellar that has two underground floors with constant temperature of 8 degrees centigrade, as well as 99 barrels of 4,000 liters each. This cellar keeps some archive wines made of domestic grape sorts, so they are the oldest ones that can be found in Serbia. For example, the bottles of Oplenka from 1931, when the royal vineyard started working, are priceless, and from later years, there are still wines with the royal crest on the bottles out of the sorts Žilavka, Prokupac, Hamburg and Plemenka. The slopes of Oplenac are also rich in other kinds of fruits, medicinal herbs and edible mushrooms, while in the village of Lipovac near the local school, one can find probably the oldest oak tree in Sumadija. A true giant with a huge crown and a trunk of 5 meters is an inspiration to the painters who traditionally gather annually in the Lipovac painting colony.